All right, we are going over here. There we go. Scorpion. Get him, my man. There we go. We're almost there. We are gonna go into this abandoned shack, see what's in here. Ooh, got first aid. Take it all this. Reloading. Reload. Reload. Take iron. Yonze Moon. Whoa, this is something. Oh god. There we go, boom, bro. That sniper is OP. That sniper be one-shotting people, man. Yeah, I can't dig these grave sites, so. Alright, we're going over here. Or we're going over here, I guess. That's where we're going. First, we're gonna save real quick. Gonna save. Damn, that's a good ass shot.
All clear.
Good shooting. I'm taking these scorpion glands because you never know. Somebody over here. Hello, my good people. Who are you?
Poor Snuffles. Wish somebody could do something about his leg.
Your leg appears to be injured. Fuck, I don't have any medicine. How's it going? I don't have any medicine for him. Well, let's go to the mess hall real quick. Got no medicine.
Poor Snuffles. Wish somebody could do something about his leg.
Let me ask you a question. What's the tastiest thing you've ever eaten?
Anything that wasn't made 20 years ago.
Yeah, can you believe some people still eat that stuff? Anyway, I've got this recipe for a deathclaw omelet that I've been itching to try out. Trouble is, I need a deathclaw egg. Kind of obvious, I suppose.
Deathclaw egg, okay. Where did you come up with this recipe?
My great-aunt Rose ran a bed and breakfast back in California, in a town called Modoc. She's the one who created the recipe in the first place. I don't know how she managed to get a hold of a female deathclaw, but she kept it in a shed. Aunt Rose had a steady supply of eggs for her omelets. At least, she did until some stranger came along and killed the deathclaw, shot it right in the eye.
Where are the offerings in exchange for a deathclaw?
I don't have much in the way of money, but I'd be willing to share the secret of the recipe.
Where can I find a deathclaw?
The quarry just north of here is full of deathclaws, so there's bound to be an egg or two in there somewhere. Of course, a deathclaw egg from anywhere will do. According to my Aunt Rose, those things have a ridiculously long shelf life.
Let's talk about something else.
All right. Do you need anything to eat or drink?
Show me what you got for sale.
Sure thing.
Yeah, I don't really have anything else. About the deathclaw opulent.
Yeah?
I don't have anything. Loki got a fix.
When do you think the NCO will send their troops to help us?
I'm not sure, my brother. Not sure. This is a mining door. Okay. So I'm gonna door to the worker barracks.
It's too damn hot.
Alright, let's get out of here. I can't fix Snuffles' leg because I don't have enough medicine. I'll come back though. I'll come back.
Hold up. There are death claws all over the damn place north of here. I'd turn back if I were you. If you want to get to New Vegas, you're better off heading east from Prim and then looping north. It's a heck of a lot safer.
Where did deathclaws come from?
They moved into the quarry after the powder gangers came through and made off with most of our dynamite. We shut the quarry down while we waited for the NCR to get us some more blasting sticks. But now the deathclaws have shown up. The NCR is a no-show. And my men and I have got nothing to do but sit on our asses all day. It's damn frustrating.
I could take care of the Deathclaw problem.
Have you ever seen a Deathclaw? They're taller than a man and far, far stronger and faster. And there's a whole pack of them out there. You'd have to be the meanest, toughest, roughest bastard in the wasteland to have any chance against them, and I don't think that's you. You'd need to take out the pack leaders, the Mother Deathclaw and the Deathclaw Alpha Male. Kill them and the pack will scatter. Pretty tough job.
Tell me about the Power Rangers.
There are a bunch of escape cons down south. The NCR was using them to maintain the railways as part of their sentence. I don't know who screwed up, but the Powder Gangers are loose. It was one group that attacked us and took our entire supply of dynamite.
Have you ever had problems with Deathclaws before?
We'd see them occasionally, but they didn't seem too keen on getting too close to the quarry. Not sure if it was the noise or all the workers. I can't believe that an entire pack moved into the quarry. I thought that kind of bad luck only happened in New Vegas.
Let's talk about something else.
Okay.
What are you telling me about
New
Vegas?
I've been there once, and I don't recommend it. It's just a way to burn through a month's pay in 5 minutes. I've seen a lot of folks come through here thinking they'll have the easy life once they get there. It never happens.
What is this place?
This is Sloan, a camp for us quarry workers. The actual quarry, Quarry Junction, is up the road north of here. The whole thing is an NCR operation. We make cement for the NCR using the limestone we dig out with dynamite and drag lines. Dirty work, but the pay's good. Wish we got paid in caps, though. Not a lot of merchants like taking NCR paper money.
What does the NCR need with the payment?
It all gets shipped by rail over towards Boulder City and Hoover Dam. The NCR is probably building fortifications with it all.
What's a drag line? What's the drag line?
It's a big machine which moves rocks around, piles at a time. It's pre-war tech, so you need to thump it once in a while to keep it running.
You don't get painted caps?
Nope. The NCR has been trying to switch over to using paper money, just like in the pre-war days. Trouble is that the exchange rates ain't exactly fair. For example, $100 in NCR money is valued at roughly half that in caps around here. Seems like a rotten deal for us, but work is work.
Let's talk about something else.
Sure.
Goodbye.
If you insist on going north, don't be expecting a rescue when you get into trouble.
All right, let's get out of here. Maybe. We're gonna save real quick.
Let shit rot. That's the call, hey, from back in the day. Hey. Yeah, just a youngin' with a dream.